So what are equivalent ratios? Equivalent ratios means when you want to compare two quantities and they are in fraction, say, or in form of ratio, how you can compare? For example, you want to compare half with 2 by 3, means 1 by 2 or 2 by 3. We need to know whether half is equal to 2 by 3, whether half is greater than 2 by 3 or half is less than 2 by 3. So the best way is to take the denominator of the second, multiply numerator and denominator by this one. So half multiplied by 3, 3. This gives you 6, 3 by 6. And here you multiply this value by the denominator of this. So into 2, into 2. This gives you 4 by 6. Now you have 3 by 6, 4 by 6. 3 by 6, 4 by 6, denominator are same. 4 and compare 4 with 3, you get 4 greater. So now you can easily say that 2 by 3 is greater than 1 by 2. This is how you compare or the ratios and making them equivalent. We have one more example. This is the performance of cricket team in the matches it played. So last year it was 8 win with 2 losses. So it is 8-1, 8-2. This year it is 4-2. How to compare 8 by 2 and 4 by 2? So this becomes 2, 4s are 8, 2 2s are 4. So 4 and 2, you know that in 4 and 2, which is the higher? 4 is higher. So the previous year or last year standing was good, or the performance was quite good. How to keep things in proportion and getting solution? See, this is a house somebody has built it. Mona has built it, and Aruna made it, and Mona said, no, there is something wrong about this figure. Aruna asked, what? See, this is the mother, and she has made the mother in the picture. And in this, mother is reaching the second floor window. So this is not up to the scale. So how the scale can be done? If mother would have been of some this height, lower than the door, then you can have said, okay, the things are fine. So how to keep things in proportion, getting solution? Then we have to find out the actual height of building by actual height of mother. Then if it is equal to height of building in drawing and height of mother in the drawing, then we say that the figure and the actual thing are in proportion. Another example you can take is the national flag of various countries. They always make like this. The length and breadth 1.5:1 or 1.7:1. Similarly, the postcard where we used to write the letters. So postcard, say 3:2 ratio. This is how we make or keep things in proportion. Unitary method. How we can apply unitary method? Unitary method, let us see. We'll try to explain things with two scenarios. Aruna does the same example, Meera does the same example. So the question is, map is given with a scale of 2 cm is equal to 1000 km. So 2 cm is equal to 1000 km. What is the actual distance between two places in kilometer? The distance in the map is 2.5 cm. So how does Aruna did it? She said x. So 2, she said 2 is to, this is the distance. So x distance we have to find for 2.5. So take x here. So 2.5 is equal to 1000 x to x. So she did exactly that. Arun did exactly that. She means Meera. So we are talking about Arun. So he did what? 1000 is to x. 1000 is to the length is equal to the map or the length in the map. So 2:2.5. So by this you can get easily x as 1250. But Meera took another way. She said, if 2 cm means 1000 km, 1 cm means 1000 by 2 km. So what about 2.5 cm? Multiply it by 2.5. Just she did that and she got the same answer. This is the unitary method. So you can get the idea that there are so many methods to solve. One is the direct proportion method, one is the unitary method. 6 balls costs 90. What would be the cost of 10 such balls? So 6 balls cost 90. One ball will cost what? 90 by 6. And if you have to find 10 balls, just multiply it by 10. If you want to find out for 20 balls, multiply it by 20. So this is the unit cost for one value, and you can multiply it with the number of times. So this is how 10 balls will come on 50. The car that I owe can go 150 km in 25 liters. So for 25 liters, it goes up to 150 km. For one liter, it will go for 150 by 25 kilometers for one liter. So for how far it will go for 30 liters. So you just have to multiply it by 30. So 150 by 25 into 30. When we talk about per or for each, that means per and for each are same. That means kilometer per hour means kilometer per each hour. That is children per teacher. That is children per teacher means children for each teacher.